So, hello everybody. I'm going to talk about the art festival Recto Verso from Laval Virtual and its virtual edition. To introduce myself quickly, I'm the founder and director of the Recto Verso Festival in Laval Virtual. In my background, I have crossed different disciplines and universities from visual art, computer graphics, robotics, to computer science and cyber psychology. For me, the different knowledges and skills were complementary and their links very precious. I did a thesis at the University Paris 8 at the Digital Image and Virtual Reality Laboratory, which allowed me to link art, science, technology, and psychology. So for 5 years, I explored the artistic creation that emerges between the real and the virtual, around the notion of presence and wonder. Two significant artworks have emerged from this PhD in research creation. The first is L'Absurde, or the Survirtuality Lab. And the other is the Christopher's Wound, which brings the spectator in a child's dreams. This artwork is still on tour with a play, Count by Jon Foss. So in my creations and research, I studied the field of virtual reality, which is for me an artistic medium. What inspires me is to go back to the history of this field and to really understand how it works. Based in particular on historical scientific writing of the domain, such as here the Treatise of the Virtual Reality, which brings together several researchers and specialists directed by Philippe Fuchs. So I'm not only interested in virtual reality with headsets, but in all the immersion and interaction in the whole continuum between the real and the virtual. And on the artistic side, I'm interested in the way artists use this field of virtual and mixed reality in search of new relationship with the spectator and the emergence of new artistic forms. For example, I interrogate how do they create the space of the encounter thanks notably to interfaces? How do they transport the spectator from the real world to the virtual world? And I'm really also interested by the art history of this field. But also in a continuity with the innovation, which constantly brings new tools and artistic forms. So at the end of my thesis, I had this desire to continue this exploration of artworks between the real and the virtual, and also to create spaces for exchange and sharing. It is from this vision that was born the Recto Verso Art and Virtual Reality Festival and the entire artistic pole at Laval Virtual. For me, the festival can show what's possible with creations between the real and the virtual. So, in 2018, the Recto Verso was created. The festival annually gathered 40 to 60 artworks and their creator. It is composed of a main exhibition of about 15 selected artworks following a call for project, the Art Envers Gallery, and an artistic itinerary in emblematic places of the city of Laval, allowing for a more open-minded exhibition of the artwork of artists, researchers, students, collective creators there. So each year, I explore the border between the real and the virtual around different current themes. For the first edition, we explored the real matter and the virtual matter and all the history of this field. After, we have explored the illusion, and this year was the body. So we are exhibiting artworks complementary to this theme and that question it. We exhibit, for example, in Recto Verso, together, artist pioneer in digital art, such as here the pioneer Julie Leparc, who came for our first edition, or artists recognized in digital art, such as here Catherine Minkham, and artists from several disciplines, such as the artwork performance, have dance is an unplaceable place. We expose also emerging artists, researchers who are exploring virtual reality as an artistic medium. And Recto Verso also interrogates the object of the virtual reality headset itself. Questioning even an organic form of representation. So we don't only use virtual reality, Recto Verso also explores the concept of virtual reality. So we have artwork that question, for example, presence, like here with the illusion of life, this robotic sea anemone. So every year I do the general creation of the artwork around the theme in order to exhibit immersive and interactive virtual artwork in real spaces. I create all the scenography and the itinerary for the spectator. But this year we have adapted all the Recto Verso festival in virtual spaces. And virtual spaces have their own properties and allow for different configurations. So this year we made a multi-platform festival. We had during 3 days of the festival 7,000 unique visitors on our website. And our Recto Verso website is a portal to enter to these different parts of the festival. For example, during the Laval Virtual, we had an art program in the Laval Virtual World. We had a Recto Verso building for networking and for some description of the Recto Verso Festival. We had an art performance also inside. We interrogate here the virtual body. It was a performance of Beth Cates, an artist researcher. We made also the vernissage for virtual gallery. And we had also 2 days of art conferences here in the Laval Virtual World. And in another part of our festival, by our Recto Verso website, we have access to the virtual gallery of the Recto Verso. The third physical edition of the Artenver Gallery, plan of the theme Real Body, Virtual Body, is postponed next year during Laval Virtual to another location. But we decide quickly to create the Artenver Gallery in virtual for this year. The idea is to have a preview of the artworks and their purpose, and also to be able to virtually move through the scenography originally planned. So as an artist, I create interactive installations and lead creative projects. I led in a few weeks of adaptation and with my small team, the creation in 3D of a virtual version of the original exhibition space in a magnificent old chapel and scenography. This year, with the thematic, we have selected 16 international artworks. So here are the 16 artworks. And for each artwork, we have interpreted a way of presenting them in a virtual space. For example, we had the videos and text presenting the artwork, so we used them. Here is another example of the artwork Uncontained. We just took the video. We also had some images that I staged in the virtual space. For example, for the artwork. And we also retrieved audio tapes to delineate the spaces, the virtual spaces of the artwork. We have taken some liberties in order to make the presentation of the artworks in space come alive as well as possible. For example, by taking images that have been taught and placed in the 3D space. Like here for the artwork, for example, jellyfish. We have also modeled in 3D elements of scenography, such as table here, shell, headset, screen, etc., to do the virtual scenography between the artworks. And elements also of the artwork, like here, this interactive display of the artwork called Existe. Or here with the swing of the curved screen, given an idea of the experience of the artwork in the space for the artwork called Self-Suspension. And we have even modeled a part of the presentation of the artwork itself, like here for iHuman. And some artists have also given us 3D model of the artwork, which we have integrated. And also some animation, like here with the artwork Body Remixer. So I have integrated this artwork, the 3D Unity engine, and I also created the interaction to move in space, in this virtual space. At the moment, there are 3 ways to visit the gallery through our website. You have the 3 minutes video, the video visit, and a simplified form of an interactive visit also on the web. So you can here interact with your keyboard and your mouse, move into this gallery. And I have also made a virtual reality version that can be diffused for the artist and in some places. And inside, you can teleport in different spaces to see the artworks. This creation reveals some interesting lines of thought for me, in particular around the question of the exhibition of immersive and interactive artworks in the virtual space. These artworks being themselves realized by the medium of the virtual. So if we reformulate how to expose in a virtual space virtual artworks, and how to represent this artwork in this virtual space? And could we experience like that the real purpose of the artwork? So it is interesting to consider virtual spaces with its own property in terms of space and time. For example, the exhibition has a beginning, but for the moment, there is no end. It can evolve in terms also of content and platforms. And in terms of space, the exhibition can be inspired by a real space, but by a complementary imaginary space with the codes of the virtual. For example, Without Gravity, as proposed by the Cyber Museum of the In Dialogue Collective. On the artist side, virtual spaces can inspire the creation of artwork only for virtual spaces. Artists can, for example, imagine variants of their real artwork, but for virtual spaces. Or they can also work only, they can also create artworks only for this space. We can see, for example, virtual artworks for virtual spaces in the experience of the Museum of Other Reality. So for me, it's opened different ways of reconsidering the festival and its real and virtual variants, both in terms of the creation of the exhibitions, as well as the new artistic forms that may emerge in this field. So, thank you and see you in our next edition.